Rabbis. Jesus, thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus.
To God be all the glory.
Jesus.
122 says, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Our feet shall stand within thy gates, O Jerusalem. Oh, hallelujah. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, God.
Jesus.
Oh, hallelujah. We give God praise today. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, we welcome you each to ministerial engagement. To God be all the glory. Where God is the head of our life.
Yes.
All King Jesus Christ.
Yes.
He is the head of our life. And
yes.
I'm honored to God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit that leads and guides us in every single thing that we do. One of the things that we do on ministerial engagement, we encourage everyone to seek to be filled with the Holy Spirit, to lead, guide you. The Holy Spirit will keep you. It will comfort you. It will, when you want to go one way, the Holy Spirit will direct you in another way that God may have you to go. And it will help you live that life according to the word of God. You hear me? It will help you to walk in God's way and in his will and in his purpose. Oh, hallelujah. I thank God for my shepherd, for my overseers, oh hallelujah, to all of Team Jesus members, every last one of you, I love you and I appreciate you. To God be all the glory. I thank God for what he's doing in each of our lives and in the ministries that he has us each going out and doing. The word of God, the gospel of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. It's so important in the season, in the time that we're in, that no one, even those that have been warming the pews, it's time that you get off the pews and that you too give that word to that person standing in the back of the line, that you give that word to maybe that child that you see, or maybe that person that comes up to your car and asks for some money, have maybe some scriptures available or something to go give to them and to be able to feed them, to encourage them to seek God even the more. And I give God all the glory for my co-laborer that is here with me today in the vineyard, one of the co-hosts, Apostle Cynthia Lane Davidson from Houston, Texas. To God be all the glory. God calls us precious, so you will hear us referring to her as Apostle Precious. And she's like my ride or die in the ministry, as well as every last single one of the members. All of them, you hear me? Each person, each Team Jesus member, Jesus Christ member, our Lord and Savior, brings their unique gifts and talents to the ministry. You hear me? And so each person is called for a reason and for a purpose, and together we make the whole, oh hallelujah, to the according to the will of God. And at this time, oh hallelujah, that I yield, actually today, God has said in John 4:24, it says, God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. That is King James version. And then in Romans 15:7, it tells us to receive ye one another as Christ also received us to the glory of God. What my prayer is today is God has given us instructions to worship him on our day back in spirit and in truth, to worship him. And as we come before the Lord God and worshiping and praising him in spirit and in truth, we're asking and praying that you, our sisters and brothers in Christ, and if you're not saved, that you come and still worship with us, because this is going to be a worship and praise experience that you have never, ever experienced before. Each worship and praise experience should bring you closer to the Lord God. It should do something on the inside. And so we invite you to as I yield to Apostle Precious, she's going to do the opening prayer. But I invite you, as Romans 15:7 tells us, to receive each other. And as God, Christ, received us in the glory of God, I pray that you receive us and that you help evangelize by sharing the broadcast or just sending it to somebody that you know needs a word, needs encouraging. Come worship with us today in spirit and truth. Oh, hallelujah. To God be all the glory. I yield to you, Apostle Precious. To God be all the glory.
Amen. Amen. Reading from 1 Thessalonians 5:17, it says, pray without ceasing.
Amen.
Pray without ceasing. Don't mean you have to be on your knees all the time, but pray in your heart. Pray while you're driving. Pray while you're shopping. Pray while you're bathing. Pray while you're cooking. Pray without ceasing.
Amen.
Say it. It don't have to be a long, drawn out prayer. Say, Lord, help. Lord, save. Lord, deliver. Lord, set free. Lord, I need to hear your voice. Lord, I need to hear your touch. Just something. God wants to hear from us. And then after we pray, prayer is not just a monologue. It's a dialogue.
Yes. Yes.
And we have to stop and listen to see what God has to say to us.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Let us bow. Father God, we just come before you today, just magnifying you, glorifying you, praising your high and your holy name in the master's name of Jesus Christ. Come on in, Holy Ghost, and pray through me right now in the name of Jesus. Have your divine will and way on today, God. Give us a mind of praise. You worship you in spirit and in truth, oh God, from the very depths of our soul, even now, la la bo shi, in the name of G, la la bo sha, ke la 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 bo ho la 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 man ni de yo si, ke la 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 bo ho la 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 man si, yay, oh, ha la la bo ho la 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 ba si, heal la bo ho la la, heal today, deliver today, set free on the day, God, la bo sha, heal somebody in the mind, the soul, and the spirit today, Lord God, la la bo si. Yay, Bamba Dola Labo, see, we realize that through you all things are possible to those that truly believe what you say in your word, Lord God. Obo Kenada Man, see, Kyobo Saba, see, Yanabosa, yay, oh, Bandela Bohola. Oh God, we need the riches of your power. We need the riches of you, God. Oh, man, oh, God, have your way, and the Lavosa. God, have your way, head out of us. God, we trusted in you, believing in you, your word today, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, glory to God,
hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, Jesus.
Thine be all the glory, to thine all the praise unto you today, God, the earth and finish your
hallelujah.
Ooh, by shaker, and Jesus is a mighty name.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I hear God saying, oh, you gotta see it. See, I am here. I am Alpha Omega. Oh, yeah, God, yeah, God, He's telling me that some of you have been through some things since you've last seen us up here. He says that he sees and he knows, oh, yeah, God, and he's heard your prayers and he heard your cries, oh, yeah, God, he says, many of you, God, yeah, God, you praise him through it. But some of you, you got heavily laden, Lord, you gotta see, and you didn't surrender it. He said, Lord, you gotta see that let everything that have breath praise the Lord. We are to praise God at all times, and no matter how bad it hurts or how bad it may feel. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you. We're to praise God through it. You might not can see what he is doing at that particular time or moment, but it will be revealed unto you. And even today, he in Psalms 119, 133, it says, order my steps in thy word, and let not any iniquity have dominion over me. And so we don't supposed to allow anything other than God have control over us. And even as we are coming before you today to do worship and worship God, he has ordered our steps on what songs to play in an order. And the order that he has given is for purpose. It's a purpose even to the songs that is played. And so I pray that you receive all that he is giving to not just one person, but to all of us. He is the Son, Jesus Christ, and that we have to pray, we have to accept him in our hearts, and that we have to pray for the Holy Spirit to guide us. And so as we go forth and play these ordered songs, because the woman of God, Apostle Davidson, and I, we've been working on this, 2 days in a row? Asking, because I've been praying before then, but asking, and God, I mean, everything that we do, we seek God's directions and his instructions as Psalms 119:33 for him to order our steps. And you too pray and ask God to order and direct your steps. And he, oh hallelujah, he's gonna bless and he's gonna do something. And so I'm going forth with the song. We do not own any rights to any of the music, but however, we encourage you to add them to your worship and praise collection. For when you are spending that one-on-one time communing with God, and don't just commune alone. Many, I've seen and I've talked to some married couples or some couples that are people in relationships, interpersonal relationships, that, and y'all are not praying enough. Come together and pray and handle things the way the word of God says, and it will stop some of this chaos and confusion that we see going on. But we must, oh hallelujah, as a woman of God, Apostle Precious says, we must pray without ceasing. And that's what God is directing. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, God. So join us as we worship and praise God on today. And believe me, there's going to be healing and deliverance as you worship and praise some of that stuff that you've been Supposed to say it afterwards, however you told me to let you know now. So as we're coming before him, he says that there are some that have not been setting the atmosphere, that there are some churches, there are some people that are gathering and say that you're gathering for the Lord God to worship and to praise him, but you are not inviting him in. You're not worshiping and you're not praising him. What you're doing is going through the motions, going through the motion of saying that you're having church, going through the motion of saying that you're doing this for the Lord God. You've gotten in habit and you are not doing God's work. You're not inviting him. He says, many of you, you have your hands in so many things. And he's not there.
Amen.
He is not there. He's saying, oh, yeah, to stop. He says to invite him in. Invite him into your worship. He says, praise him at all times. But it is to stop. You're doing it. You doing it. And allow God in. In Jesus' name, thank you, God.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah, 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 thank you, God, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, oh, Jesus, Jesus, hallelujah, thank you, God. Thank you, God. Oh, dear. Thank you. Jesus, I lift up Maria K. Ian and what she's going through in her mother's house. In the name of Jesus, that your goodness shall shine through in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior's name. Amen. So we're worshiping and praising you in advance, God.
So my life, you have been faithful.
Yes, Jesus.
Oh, my life, you have been so. So good.
Yes.
With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire.
Yes.
In darkest night. You are close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend. And I have lived in the goodness of God. Hey, 'cause all my life you have been faithful. Oh, yes, you have. All my life, you have been so, so good.
Yes.
Every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. Your goodness is running after, it's running after. To me.
Yes, hallelujah.
Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender to, I give you everything, oh Lord. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, oh yeah.
Faithful Lord.
So good with
Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus.
This is
Jesus.
Nobody told me. No, 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 no. This road was gonna be easy. No, they didn't tell me. No, they didn't tell me. Oh, no, 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 no. They didn't tell me that, y'all. But I don't believe he's brought me this far. Don't believe he's brought you this far. Do you mind if I sing it just one more time, y'all? Is that all right, somebody?
God.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. I don't believe. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, God.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That song, oh, hallelujah, it meant a lot because while it was playing, I heard God say, he says that some of you, you get out of the race before God has told you to. Stop because the battle is too hard. Mm-hmm. And God's not telling you to stop. He's not telling you to give up. He's telling you to go forth. He let me know too that of course the enemy knows your future, and so what he does is that he puts things in place. He will use events, he will use situations, he will even use people. And it don't matter who, if they call themselves saved or not saved or whatever, he will use anything and anything to stop you from your and you get out the race, you get out without him telling you to. Your growth, your growth is being able to go through that test and stand in it and through it, praising God all the way. And through it all, you cut your blessings. And you wonder why you're not getting blessed. You wonder why. It's because it's you that's doing it. Mm-hmm. That you can get a misconceived notion, or you can think this way or feel that way. And then instead of talking about it, and then what happens is you allow, because once that portal is open, God is saying, you allow more stuff to come in, and you get out of the race, and he's not telling you. And now I'm going to go back and give you what he said earlier. He said also, healing is here. Restoration is here. He also said that children are seeing things that they should not be seeing. They're hearing things that they should not be hearing. And God is telling me to tell the guardians to protect them. He says to protect them, to protect their ears, to protect their eyes. Jesus, Lord, Apostle Precious, did God give you anything else on that?
Okay. He gave me something, but he gave me something else. About when, going back to what you were saying about having that worship when you go to church.
Yes.
God says many people don't know how to get into that place when they go into the building, because they're not being taught how to get into that worship place.
Amen. Yes.
And when we were coming up, when you went to church, the sanctuary was sacred. we were taught that there were certain things that could not go on because we wanted the Spirit of God to speak to us, to do some things in us. And he's saying they need to be taught again. So this is for the leaders.
Amen, amen.
Leaders, the church I go to, they play music to set the atmosphere. And when the music's playing, it gets the people's mind on what they need God to do in their lives. So go back to the old landmark. Go back to setting the atmosphere. If you need to, get on your knees. Talk to God when you get to the church house. Don't be so quick to gather together and be laughing and talking. Get your mind on the Lord before you get there and while you're in the building so God can come in and move
Jesus.
In your life.
Jesus.
We want God to move, but we're not in that place when we get to the building.
Yes.
We're not there. So if you're not there when you get to the building, you can get there once you get there. Get on your knees. Get into that place with God.
Yes, yes.
So your children can know how to worship God in spirit and truth. So deliverance can come to yourself and somebody else that might come in and not be saved, might not be delivered. And they come in, they get into the atmosphere where God comes in and envelops everyone that's in the building.
Amen, amen. And God was letting me know, that yes, we aren't doing worship the way that we have in the past. We're doing it the way that God is guiding us right now because there's been a switch. You hear me? And that's why it is so important to have the Holy Spirit to when God shifts the atmosphere, shifts it, tells you to go do something. You do it. But we should not always be doing things the same. We should be able to have God in every single thing that we do. It can be somebody. The man of God or the woman of God can be preaching a whole word. And one person could walk in the church.
Mm-hmm.
God know that that person might not come to that church again. It might just be a visitor.
Right.
But God is reaching out because he sent that person to come there that particular time. That man or woman of God do not supposed to suppress the spirit and allow the Holy Spirit to move him or her and preach or say whatever it is that needs to be said. And if that word needs, I don't care if you've got a whole bunch of stuff wrote or you've done preach or ready to preach, put it down and do exactly what God is telling you to. And that person's life is on at stake. You don't know if that person it's going to die that next night or later on that day or whatnot. And you can be giving that person a life-giving word.
Yes.
It happened. And you missed that opportunity. God is going to hold you accountable for that. Thank you.
And
you can hear him say, stop scattering my sheep. Stop scattering my sheep. Yes, we're trying to worship God, but if God gives us something to say, you better say it. Because there's someone.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Lord, we praise the God. We do. We're going to go forth on and continue to praise him. So come on and praise him. Stay with us because God, I tell you what, he's moving. He said he was here. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. And he is always with us. Always. Hallelujah. Thank you, God.
Just like
thank you,
afraid to dream of
life.
You won't make sense to everybody. You need courage if you're gonna persevere.
This is for that person that needs courage. You're here worshiping God, you're going through something, and it's still scary. It may be that move, it may be that new job, that new situation, a new relationship, maybe a separation or a breakup.
But
God wants you to know that he is here. Keep the faith, don't praise him, don't worship. come through it all and let him let go of it. Oh, hallelujah. Don't
glory to God.
Don't give up. You can feel, don't you know you're almost there?
Oh, yeah, you've got an answer when you're called. So don't be afraid to face the world.
Today is that day to start making the Lord the Lord of your life.
Never give up.
Hallelujah. Thank you, God.
Yes. Hallelujah.
That song, it meant a lot to me, and it means a lot. That both of them, the one that says, I can't believe that you brought me this far to leave me and never give up. And then the one that's playing, because of many times our life isn't always a bowl of cherries. There's hurt. There's pain. Many of you may not know, but both Apostle Precious and I, we've been homeless before. I mean, not knowing where we're going to sleep at, that we've gone through the throughs of life. We've gone through hurt, through pain, through suffering, not being liked, because when you serve God, you're going to get thrown at.
Amen.
Like people would be doing stuff and they don't even know why they're doing it. We do. It's an enemy. But we gotta forgive them and we gotta go forth on and love on them still. It hurts, but God will take the hurt away. He will take the pain away. You hear me? That last night at Apostle Precious, when I was laying down in the bed, I looked at I got like, what is it, Laugh, Live, and Love with some butterflies on my bedroom wall. And as I was laying there, I was looking at it, and I could think back at that time when my children were young and I lost everything. And I didn't have nowhere to go at that time. And I was the tobacco field that I was working at, picking cotton. and putting it in a tobacco barn. I rode out there to that, I call it like a little plantation, and I drove the car up to where I sold all the appliances that I could go get this little junk car. It was cold, it was snow on the ground. And it was so cold that night. And back in that time period, I mean, the nights were cold. And I had to cut on and off the car engine trying to keep my babies warm because the baby girl, Layla, she was only something like about 3 months old. And the other, she was like two. And I was like, and they were hungry. And I was like, Lord Jesus, what do I do? And I remember that day looking up to the Lord God. And I reached out to him. I said, God, what do I do? I don't know what to do. I was only something like, I was married and separated. I was only like 23 at the time. I didn't know what to do. I didn't. So I looked up to the Lord God. I knew to do that. Yeah. And I just knew, don't give up. And he guided me. And he told me where to go. He was talking to me all the way back then. And so when things look bleak, don't give up. Always keep going. Talk to God in those moments when you are sad and when you're hurt, when you don't know where else to go, when there's no one there. God is there. He will listen to you. He will guide you. You just have to be willing to be able to reach out. Life isn't always easy. It can be difficult. Even coming up here, it's like the warfare is unreal. It really is. And that you get tired in your body. But God, you don't give up, because God don't give up on us. We keep going. We're going to be like the Energizer Bunny Rabbit and keep going for God. You hear me? I still didn't give my life to Christ then. And so I was years living in sin. So you hear me? I got years to make up for the Lord God. And I'm going to evangelize. I'm going to, every time I have a breath, somebody says, Bonnie, is that all you talk about is the Lord? Yes. Because if he saved me, he healed me, and I'm going to worship him. We're going to worship him. We're going to praise him. Because we love him and we know what God has brought us from, and that we still go through. We go through some of the crazier crazies. But through God, he makes it seem not bad. And when you praise him through it, it's growth. So stop getting all bent out of portion when things don't go your way. Stop giving up. Stop losing hope and faith. You hear me? We got to trust in God. In Hebrews, it says that faith is the substance of things hoped for, things not seen. So you got to have that faith. Yeah. All things, was it Philippians 4:13? All things are possible through Christ Jesus that strengthens us. So let us continue to worship and praise the Lord God in the name of Jesus. And Apostle Precious, if God has given you anything at any time, you already know. And I already know, you know, you're going to pop right on in. Because when God switches stuff, he switches it for reason and for purpose, because he knows who's up here and he knows who's going to be watching. Amen. So he comes through a mighty ways to give us a word. And this is Still Our Rise by Yolanda Adams. And this, hallelujah, this is our testimony. This is our testimony. This is all of our testimony. Those that have went through. Oh, hallelujah. I see you up here, Apostle Lightner. This is your testimony too. Oh, hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes. Yes, yes.
The time will heal.
Yes, yes. And I see you up here, my Aunt Delana Gomez, Pedros, and Maria Ann, and Dolores Davis, and Ann Ramford, and all those that have made a comment. We're going to continue to rise up. Oh, hallelujah. Yes.
But here I stay. Still I press on, no more the nights.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, God.
Hallelujah, woman of God. Oh, hallelujah. There's been a shift. Hold on one moment. Let me stop this. I think I just stopped it right here. Hold on. Yes, yes. To God be all the glory.
Thank you, Jesus.
I'm sure that you felt it also. However, God, he was giving me instructions to pray.
Mm-hmm.
One of the things that you, what's going to happen, the more that you seek God and the more that you're with him and establish that one-on-one relationship, it's like different levels. There are different devils that you deal with, and mm-hmm. that there's things that it's going to try to stop you and each one of us from our purpose and for our Amen. Destiny. They don't mm-hmm. want particular people blessed. They don't want people, and the enemy wants to stop you, and that's why you have to go and praise God all the way through it and let nothing, absolutely mm-hmm. nothing, stop you. However, God will let you know what it is that you're coming and faith mm-hmm. and what you're going against. Even when you're going through spiritual warfare, I'm gonna mm-hmm. tell you, God will even show you the person's face and give you their name. So rock on that shit. And right now he's telling me to go into prayer at first, and then after we go into the prayer, and we don't usually do altar calls at worship, but we doing what God is saying, because there are some, I don't know if you're up here now or that you're going to be coming, but some of you are going through some spiritual warfare, and God is telling me to come forth and do a prayer to come against spiritual warfare, to come against the spiritual wickedness in high places, to come against these demonic forces, come against these bridges and these things that's been placed there to take you out, to hurt or hinder, to break up and split up, because no weapon formed against thee shall prosper. That is the word of God, and you have to stand on the word of God, and you have to believe. And it doesn't matter right now if you are saved or not saved. Right now, the thing that's important is that we all come together right now.
Yeah, amen.
Oh, hallelujah. So I'm going to start it off with repentance first. Yes. After I pray, I'm turning it over to Apostle Davidson, and she's going to lead you in a prayer of salvation. And then God will lead her from that point. And then, so Lord, God, in the mighty name of Jesus, God. Cover us, Lord God, all with the blood of Jesus, from the crown of our head is to the sole of our feet. As I God, with what your will is guiding me to do, God, in the name of Jesus. Lord God, oh yeah, gotta say first, God, we repent for every sin that we have committed in deed, in thought, in action. God, I pray that you even forgive those, God, that have purposely went out to hurt and harm people, God. People that have participated in all type of spiritual wickedness, less than sin, God, of the flesh, God. Lord, I also pray in the name of Jesus that if all things that are hidden within each person that it's up here or watches, God, Lord, that you do a spiritual search on them, God, and all hidden sins, God, that the word of God tells us, Lord God, all hidden sins or hidden things in them, God, sins that they do that they don't even recognize as a sin, God, that you make it known to them, God, and that they sin no more in the name of Jesus, God. We pray, God, in the name of Jesus, that you bind up, God, every imp, every demonic spirit, every witch, all forms of witchcraft, non-well wishes, God, spiritual wickedness, high places, demons of the airwaves, God, things that have been sent to stop your work, God, to stop your will, God. In the name of Jesus, I pray, God, that you bind any and all things that are not of you, God, up in the name of Jesus. It got not my nothing. And all things, oh hallelujah, that is bound, God, that you cast it, God, to where you will have it to go, God. It got da da see. Release the blood, God, the blood, or you're gonna see of Jesus, God, that would destroy any and all remnants and yokes, God. Release your anointing, God. Jesus, Jesus. Someone that I don't know if you're here now or that's going to be watching, however you're dealing with, I see two demonic forces that is behind you. And it's not behind you in your what I'm saying in the past, but it's there in the present. I see shadowy things. So Lord God, those things that are there, God, in the name of Jesus, God, I pray that you bind it up and cast it. It's you gotta that sign. You gotta see what is it? That you gotta that sign, you gotta see. It is demonic infestation. It's something that is in a chair or furniture or something, but it's in the place or facility that you're at. God said to many of you, you go out to the stores or you go out to secondhand stores. There's nothing wrong with that. However, some of these things got things that are attached to it. You don't pray over it. You don't pray before you go into a new thing and you leave. Those spirits can come to with you. It can attach itself. So the same way that I prayed a while ago, you are to pray that prayer or a prayer similar to it, to bind up and cast out and ask God to purge it with the blood and the anointing of God. And to cleanse the place that you're staying in. So Lord God, I pray God that you, Lord God, anoint God, this place afresh in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, God. Lord, you're showing me that the woman, she's light complexion and she got dark hair, God. Actually, it's two, God. Lord God, both of them are dealing with something, God, that is supernatural, God. I pray that you guide them, God. They're both seeking you, God, because they know that they're in a spiritual battle. I pray, Lord God, that you equip both, God. With whatever, God, that is needed by you as they go forth in this battle. I rebuke all fear. Lord God, I pray also, God, for Miss Ann. God, she's in her mother's house. God, I saw the note. She's dealing, Lord God, with spiritual wickedness. There's a lot of chaos and confusion in her house, God. I pray, Lord God, the prayer that one of the houses, God, I don't know if that was the house or not, God, but Lord God, I'm understanding, and we're touching and agreeing on the prayer. I just pray, God, that, Lord God, in this household, it is well, God. You got to we come against the profanity and the cursing, God, and come against your people, God, in the name of Jesus. God is calling me too to say now that there are many that you're seeing that you're saved, that you know God, but at home you aren't showing it. You're calling every people all kind of names except for the child of God. Your mouth is full of filth. Filthy lucre. You're cursing out people. You're calling them names. You're showing instability. You're double-minded in your ways. You're wicked. And God says to repent and to get it right. And this is what's going on somewhere to where children are seeing it. I wonder why the children are the way that they are. Because you're opening the children up in portals. Their eyes and ears have become a portal. And next thing you know, you're going to be why they're acting the way. And they've taken on those spirits that are within you. So keep your children and keep yourself protected. Cover yourself with the blood of Jesus. Go in and anoint your house with the blood of Jesus. Spiritual warfare is real. Satan, house divided against itself, cannot stand. That is the word of God.
Yes.
You cannot cast out Satan if you are not saved. You have to be saved. You have to know God.
Yes.
You need to be filled with the Holy Spirit, because those demons will jump up on you and beat you down. That's in the word of God.
Yes, they will.
So you have to be saved, filled with the Holy Spirit, and live righteous. God is telling me also to say many of you are being contaminated. If you don't pray and ask God who should pray for you, and you got people laying hands on you and praying for you that need deliverance themselves.
Yes, amen.
It doesn't matter if somebody directs you to somebody else to go to, if God didn't tell you to go to that person.
Right.
And so, Lord God, I pray in the mighty name of Jesus, God. I pray, Lord God, for any Robert, Lord God. I pray for Maria Ann. I pray for Dolores Davis, God. I lift up, Lord God, Delana Gomez, Lord God. I lift up all those that have not wrote a prayer request, God, but not prayer, God. Lord, I touch and agree with every righteous prayer, every prayer of need, God. of deliverance, God, that needs to take place, Lord God. I touch and agree, God. We touch and agree that your will be done, God, in the name of Jesus, that there be healing, that there be peace in the midst of the storm. God, I also pray for every person that have prayed those prayers that are against another person. I pray that you convict them and convert them, God, to where, Lord God, then stop them from praying purgatory and witchcraft prayers. Bind up that demon spirit in them, God, to where it cannot operate and come against your people, God. We pray for their mercy and their grace and their salvation. We pray that your will, God, is done in Jesus' name, God. I pray, Lord God, also that I've done and we have done everything that you said and asked us to do, and we have not left anything undone, God. So, Lord God, as Apostle Precious, as she does the altar call, and we pray the last song, God, I pray that you continue to work on this person until she does the benediction, God. I pray that all shackles fall and are cast away. I pray that everyone is filled that is not filled, and those that are filled with the Holy Spirit, that they be refilled. I pray that your will be done. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen. And for those that thought that we were gone, that just like we've been playing, you don't give up.
Amen.
On us, and we don't give up on God. So we haven't been anywhere. We deal with God and have been communing with God. And I suggest that when you don't see us up here, you know, hey, it's time to commune with God. It's time to go even higher and closer in the Lord God. So just take it for granted that they're gone. We're not going to give up. We got work to do for the kingdom in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. I yield to you, Apostle Precious.
Amen. Reading Romans 10, verse 9, 8, 9, and 10. But what saith this? But what saith it? The word is nigh thee, even in thy mouth and in thy heart. That is the word of faith which we preach. That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. Amen. All you have to do is say, Lord Jesus, I'm a sinner. I don't know you like I want to. I don't know you like I should, but I ask you to forgive me for all my sins, all my transgressions, everything that I did wrong. I ask you to forgive me even now, Lord Jesus. I ask you to wash me, cleanse me, deliver me, set me free, and fill with the precious gifts of the Holy Ghost. You said over in Romans 10, verse 9, if I should confess with my mouth the Lord Jesus, shall believe in my heart that you raised him from the dead, I shall be saved. I confess that Jesus, Lord, he came, he hung, he bled, he died. He was put into a tomb, but he rose on the third day for my sins, for my transgressions. And I believe it and I receive it. Yeah. I receive him as my Lord and my Savior. And I ask you to take over my life, take over everything in me, and lead and guide me to where you would have me to go, to be taught, to be instructed, to be delivered and be set free, and show me what I need to do to get refilled with the Holy Ghost. So show me everything I need to get rid of, to give it up to you, so I can be filled with the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus, because I need the comfort, I need a keeper in my life. And I thank you for it right now in the name of Jesus. Father God, I'm back, so I walked away, but I want to come back home and be reclaimed back into the fold and refilled with the Holy Ghost. I thank you. Forgive me for turning my back on you. I haven't had any peace since I left, but I want peace back into my life. I want to be a leader in my house if I'm a man. I want to be subjected to my husband if I'm a woman. I want to do it your way and not my will. Not my way, but your will be done. I thank you for receiving me back into your fold. Thank you for receiving me back as your child in Jesus' matchless and mighty name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. To God be all the glory. I'm going to play I Trust You by James Fortune. And during the time period, allow God to come in and do a work in you. And while it's playing, Apostle Davidson and I are going to be interceding for you. In Jesus' name, amen.
One of the most difficult things to deal with, find yourself in a storm. While in that storm, it seems like everyone who you thought you could count on has walked away. Sometimes it seems like even God himself has forgotten about you. But in spite of that, to still be able to lift your head and say, Lord, I trust you.
I can see and my hands feel your touch. I will trust you, Lord. How I love you so much. Though my life's facing low and I feel so alone, Lord, my trust is in you.
I can't do this by myself.
I surrender to you. So many painful thoughts trouble through my mind, and I wonder how I will make it through.
It's not easy.
Lord, it's not easy. Sometimes the pain in my life
makes you seem so far away.
Far away. I'll trust. I need to know.
As long as I'm here for you, I know I can make it.
Through the tears and the pain.
Thank you, Jesus.
The heartache and rain.
God, I trust you. Sometimes it's so hard because everything that I see tells me not to believe.
Everything that I see tells me not to believe. But I'll trust you, Lord. You have never failed me. My past still controls me.
Things that happened to me 10 years ago.
That's hurt ever leak.
Yeah.
I can only trust you. No one loves like you.
But it's the thoughts in my mind.
So painful thoughts.
I will make it.
I will make it through.
Oh God, but I trust you.
I'll trust. Lord, it's not easy.
Sometimes the pain in my life,
pain,
oh God, it makes you seem so far away. Can I get a witness, somebody? But God, I trust you.
I need to know you're here.
Through the tears.
The
anybody ever had to cry late in the midnight hour? Every tear you've had to cry.
Through the
heartache and rain. Come on, take it out through the tears. Oh, that's right, through the
heartache.
Listen, somebody's going through something right now, and the devil's trying to convince you that there's no way you can make it out. And he says you're not going to be able to get out of this situation, but I wish somebody would make the devil out of a lie right now and lift your hands and say, God, I will trust you. I don't know how you're going to do it. I don't know when you're going to show up. But God, I know you're going to do it. God, I know you're going to bring me out. Oh, if that's you, come on, lift your voice and say, I will. Oh, that's right. I'll trust you. Hallelujah. Oh, God, I don't know when the pain's going in. But I know, God, you wouldn't put more on me than I can bear. So I trust you. In spite of what I see, in spite of what I'm going through, I trust you. God, you never left me. I know you love me. That's why I trust you. Come on, now you take it up. I had my heart broken. I made some mistakes. God, you still kept me. Oh, God, you're faithful. You see what I'm going through. You know my pain. I trust you. It's not easy for me, but I trust you. I know you're here with me. I'm not by myself. As long as I got you, Jesus, I can make it. I trust you.
Yeah. Yes. Multiplied unto you through the knowledge of God and of Jesus Christ. 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 2, King James Version. Amen.
Amen, amen, amen. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Love you, be blessed in the Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Praise God, praise God. Tomorrow at 6:30, join us. Join us. God has something special. Worshiping Him, even though we're ending now. I love you, about to precious.
Love you too. Love you.
Hallelujah. And thank you, hallelujah, for each one of y'all for joining. And give us the time to contact you back, because we all got church tonight too. So we love you. Be blessed in the Lord. And thank you for joining.